Meantime, casino operator The Star has flagged hundreds of job cuts and asset sales as the company looks to reset after posting a loss of $1.7 billion in the recent financial year. Joining me now is our business reporter, Edward Boyd. Ed, investors will be closely watching the share price. The market has just opened this morning. So how's it going to trade?
Look, it's a little too early to see the immediate reaction. Remember, The Star hasn't been trading for a bit over a month. They went into trading halt on the 30th of August, and today is day one where they resume. Look, the futures market was showing shares were at 45 cents. They're showing it was potentially going to open at 39 cents this morning. So quite a steep fall, almost a 10% fall in the share price is expected. We'll get confirmation of that at about 10:30, 10:40 a.m. Once it's all gone through the stock market and the opening trades. But really, The Star's been in serious trouble for the past month. They've been talking closely with their lenders, and then yesterday they finally lodged their full year accounts and financial reports, basically showing a loss of $1.7 billion in the recent financial year, challenging trading conditions. The new chief executive of The Star, Steve McCann, held an investor call yesterday afternoon where he said they're facing a short-term liquidity crisis, a balance sheet challenges as well. So they do have this $200 million in funding that they've secured, but there are some big ongoing problems for The Star. They need to continue to cut costs. And that could mean cutting about 300 jobs, which is what Steve McCann has flagged yesterday. It's unclear what part of the business they'll come from at this stage. There's also the possibility of The Star selling some of its car parking facilities around its casinos to raise a bit of extra cash. So this is a company that really needs to raise funds quickly to keep going. Today also, Laura, they're expected to respond to the New South Wales Independent Casino Commission's show cause notice. So we should get that happening in the next few hours as well. So busy day, busy couple of weeks actually for The Star's management team, and it's going to be a lot of sleepless nights ahead, I'd imagine.
Yeah, I think so. That is a tough, stressful job for the new CEO of The Star. Let's talk about the chairman of Qantas now, or the former chairman of Qantas, Richard Goyder. He's admitted to making mistakes while he was chairman of the airline.
Yeah, look, so John Mullen, he is now the chair of Qantas. He took over 2 weeks ago, but obviously Richard Goyder was the chair of Qantas for quite a few years, obviously through the pandemic years, through the Alan Joyce leadership time of Qantas as well. Obviously, Alan Joyce, the former CEO of Qantas, finished up last year. And Richard Goyder's done a sort of exit interview today in the Financial Review papers, just reflecting on some of his regrets as chair. Basically, it was a time where there was very high prices charged for customers. We had the Qantas settling with the ACCC last year, paying them $120 million over booking ghost flight tickets. That was basically a bit of a regret for Goyder. He hasn't actually gone into too much detail on what mistakes he's made. It's sort of the general gist of the article is, yeah, there were some problems, but it was a tough time for the aviation market and we did the best job we could. There was also the unlawful sacking of 1,700 ground staff, which happened last year as well. And that came through the courts last year, and that basically resulted in Alan Joyce leaving Qantas. So Richard Goyder is still the chairman of Woodside, and that company's facing some challenges as well. They've got their annual general meeting coming up in a couple of months, and there's major shareholders that are a bit worried about the performance of Woodside in recent months. So Goyder's finishing up at Qantas. I'm sure he'll be at the AFL Grand Final festivities this weekend. but John Mullen's the new chair, and we'll have the Qantas AGM later this year as well.
Yeah. AFL being the bright spot there, I think.
Absolutely.
Ed, thanks so much. Keep an eye on that share market for us. We'll see you soon.